Pop it in. Good afternoon, everybody, ladies and gentlemen. And let me see if we'll go ahead and get our audio on. Half a day. Okay, we're on. I want to thank each and every one of you, ladies and gentlemen, for being here this afternoon and joining me to commend and recognize, I'd like to say, three accomplished individuals who have shown exceptional dedication and commitment to our island, to our people, and to our nation. And I was speaking with the Sergeant Major earlier, and I said, okay, I want to work this through rank first. So, and she said, Senator, you did it right. So if I may, I just want to call Captain Jeannie Comlish and her son up here to join me before I do the, hopefully it'll give me time to see if the Vice Speaker would join me in a bit, but he really wanted to be here. He just got a call and he couldn't run away from that. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, every so many years people come into our lives and they do take the opportunity, not just because of their job, but they rise above the call of duty. They want to help make a difference. They meet our community. They fall in love. And then, you know, they have to leave. And our people of Guam wanted to make sure that we did something special. She takes the time to do it for her staff, and I guess the families that are with her. And I had the opportunity, ladies and gentlemen, to come into a gathering not too long ago, a couple of weeks ago, up at Naval Hospital, and just seeing the families come to together to celebrate Heritage Month and all the different island nations during FESPAC. And we had tried all the food, the different foods that were there, and just making it happen for her employees and their families. And I was given that opportunity, and then I get hit hard and saying, I'm really leaving. So, you know, we wanted to make sure that we recognized her. And ladies and gentlemen, this resolution 398-33 LS, and I want to share with you all the resolutions presented today, is there are all legislative session resolutions. They were voted on session floor. They will be archived for generations to come. So 2-3 generations later, if your children, grandchildren want to find information about you, they can look it up on our legislative journal and they'll find it. This first resolution, ladies and gentlemen, is relative to recognizing and commanding Captain Jeannie B. Comlish for her dedication and selfless service in caring for the medical needs of the military personnel and civilian at the United U.S. Naval Hospital Guam, and to further extending an Dångkolo na situs masi to her for her support and vast exemplary contributions to the military community and our people of Guam. I want to share with you that Captain Comlish is a native of Washington, D.C. She received her bachelor's degree in nursing with honors from Georgetown University in 1986 and began her career as a staff nurse at George Washington University Hospital. She was commissioned a lieutenant junior grade in September of 1990. She earned a master's of science and clinical nurse specialist trauma critical care nursing degree. She completed officer indoctrination school in Newport, Rhode Island in 1992. She deployed with Fleet Hospital 6 in support of Operation Provide Promise to the Zagreb, Croatia from March to August of 1994. In 1995, Captain Comlish went on to become the medical programs officer and department head of officer programs for the district. Captain Comlish reported as a nurse manager, emergency department at Naval Hospital Okinawa, Japan in 1998. Captain Comlish reported aboard the USS Carl Vinson CVN-70 for duty as ship nurse in January of 2000. She participated in the initial phases of Operation Enduring Freedom, the nation's response to the events of 9/11 and in the fall of 2001. I want to share with you, ladies and gentlemen, that Captain Comlish was assigned as service manager, colorectal, vascular, plastic, and pediatric outpatient surgery clinics at the National Naval Medical Center in Bethesda, Maryland in 2002 to 2004. In 2004, she assumed her duties as senior nurse, executive director of nursing services aboard the USNS Mercy, TAH-19. In January of 2005, she deployed in support of Operation Unified Assistance. Captain Comlish deployed again for humanitarian assistance missions in the Philippines, Bangladesh, Indonesia, and East Timor in April of 2006. Captain Comlish served as a division officer, department head. In 2009, she reported to Naval Hospital Camp Pendleton as a senior nurse executive director of nursing services. In August of 2012, she reported as executive officer of the Naval Hospital Oak Harbor. She effectively leads command through the 257 line item POA and M that was deployed to assist and prepare the command for the Joint Commission Survey and Navy Inspector General. She decreased enrollee ER utilization by 35%. She leveraged healthcare resources and technology to provide the highest quality of care to the command's beneficiaries. She was a key contributor to the opening of the new Navy Exchange at the command. Captain Comlish supported the Dynamic Defense Policy Review Initiative and the evolving requirements of the U.S. Marine Corps buildup of Guam. She was a key facilitator between the United States Naval Hospital Guam stakeholders and the project delivery team that worked on developing the new clinics on Naval Base Guam and Anderson Air Force Base. Captain Jeannie Comlish partnered with the University of Guam School of Nursing for their senior year leadership practicum. Captain Jeannie Comlish implemented the inaugural Guam Healthcare Coalition. She developed the first common operating picture for Guam's medical for government and non-government use. She provided assistance to Task Force 71 Naval Special Warfare Unit, one via mental health response team. And I just want to say, ladies and gentlemen, this is just a few of Captain Comlish's accomplishments while assigned in the various parts of the world in the United States Naval Hospital Guam and her services on the island. Captain Comlish will be missed by many of whom has worked alongside with and whom she has partnered with the civilian community. And I just want to say, ladies and gentlemen, that with everything that she's done, she's truly brought the collaboration between all the hospitals here, and we hope that her vision and her mission to bring our people and our community together as one team hospital, one team Guam. I just want to extend an Dångkolo na si Zeus Masi on behalf of the 33rd Guam Legislature and our people of Guam. You know, ladies and gentlemen, she usually is the one giving everybody the awards and telling everybody how good everybody is, and she forgets about herself. And I just want to say I didn't want her to leave Guam without sharing the love that she has shared with us back to her, and know that she has a special place here on Guam, you know, her home away from home when she goes back, and that she's welcome here anytime because at heart she has that Chamorro spirit. So if I may, at this time, I'm going to ask Ms. Tina, thank you, again, present this official, ladies and gentlemen, it's 2 pages long, again, on behalf of the 33rd Guam Legislature, we wish you the very best on all that you do for our people, for our nation, for our country, and the freedoms that we live today, but more importantly, for the medical assistance that you give to personnel and civilians at the United U.S. Naval Hospital and your next duty station. It's going to be hard for us to see you leave, but we want to share the love back. So again, un dankl na si Zeus Masi. Before we do an official photo, I'd like for her to say a few words, because she really has come through with the Guam leaders here and really put a good team together. And I hope that the programs that you've initiated here will really help our people and that they keep it facilitating and going. So please.
Thank you so much, Senator Barnes. My son Andrew and I were really welcomed on the island, and it is an absolutely beautiful island. And I remember when we had someone come to the hospital for a visit shortly after I took over, and they were from the facilities department, and they asked, what do you like the most about the hospital? And I think that she was asking me about the facility, but I said what I liked the most was the people in it. And that's what I feel about Guam. It has been the most wonderful experience in meeting just people that really care about family, about community, and to be a part of the One Guam concept has been awesome. And we've had a chance to forge a really wonderful team with the other two hospitals on island, Guam Memorial Hospital Authority and Guam Regional Medical City. And working with those folks has been such an honor and a privilege as we look at Guam and say, how can we, as a team of hospitals, help improve the health of Guam? And it's really been our focus, all three of us, plus anyone in the community, public health, Guam Public Health, Guam Behavioral Health. It has really been a joint effort, and I know that my replacement, Captain Dan Cornwell, our change of commands on the 30th of June, we will be changing hands, but he will share that same goal for participating with Guam and making this island just the best island ever and the best place to live, the best place to work. So thank you so much again for having us.
Andrew, we'll take a fast photo and then we'll do the second resolution. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this second resolution goes out to a family member of mine, and it's resolution 397-33LS, and it's going out to Elizabeth Pereira Perez, and she's right, but her family's here. I'm going to ask my family to come up. Auntie Gina, Uncle Joey, Joey Dosey, please come up and join me on behalf of your daughter and sister. Aww. Come on. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this resolution 397-33LS is relative to congratulating and commending Elizabeth Pereira Perez on her promotion to the rank of Chief Warrant Officer Three, U.S. Army on February 9, 2016, and to further extending an Dångkolo and a Sijus Masi to her for her dedication and selfless service and sacrifices to our people of Guam and her country. Chief Warrant Officer Perez is a native of Guam. She is the daughter of Joey and Gina Pereira, sister to Joseph, who I call Joey, sister-in-law to Jackie, and auntie to Dosey. She is the wife to Philip and the mom to Camille. Chief Warrant Officer Perez is a graduate of my alumni, Academy of Our Lady of Guam, and the University of Guam. She was also graduated cum laude there with honors. Chief Warrant Officer Perez enlisted in the United States Army in 2002 as a paralegal specialist and worked her way to the ranks of Staff Sergeant and served as a Warrant Officer. Chief Warrant Officer Perez's military education includes paralegal specialist advanced individual training, primary leadership and development courses, basic non-commissioned officer course, warrant officer candidate course, judge advocate general's warrant officer basic course, and judge advocate general warrant officer advanced course. Chief Warrant Officer Perez serves as the senior legal administrator for the office and staff judge advocate. She serves as the advisor to the staff judge advocate. Chief Warrant Officer Perez leads, mentors, and trains all assigned legal personnel. She supports the legal organization and all legal personnel who provide comprehensive legal services to commanders, units, and other organizations. And ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a delightful pleasure and an honor to present this certificate to this resolution, that was voted on session floor by all my colleagues and approved by all my colleagues. It was introduced by myself, by Speaker B.J. Cruz, Senator Frank Blush Jr., Senator Tony Ada, and Senator Respecio. And again, on behalf of the 33rd Guam Legislature and our people of Guam, to you, Uncle Joey, and to Gina, congratulations to your daughter. And she continues to make Guam proud and our people proud in all the work that she does. And I didn't want our island to go without recognizing the good work that she does for the freedoms that we live for today. So thank you. Yes. Would you like to say a few words?
My sister is in Germany right now, and they're watching a little video there. So, but I guess on behalf of my sister, thank you, Senator Tina Marie Barnes, for this recognition. She's a hard worker, and she never stops. So,
I'm proud of her.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sister.
Thank you. Let's take a picture. No. I do apologize, ladies and gentlemen. I did forget to tell you guys that the whole island of Guam is watching these resolution presentations. And, I think it's truly an honor and a pleasure to be able to share that. So with that being said, I do have one more. And I'd like to call this gentleman up. It's Sergeant Major Mark Sablan Ishmael. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Resolution 399-33 LS is relative to recognizing, commanding, and congratulating Command Sergeant Major Mark Sablan Ishmael on the occasion of his retirement after 31 years, and he still looks very young. 31 years of service to the Guam Army National Guard does extend a warm and sincere and Dångkolo na si Tsuspasi to him for his dedication, selfless service, and sacrifice to the people of Guam and our country, and thus further extend best wishes to him in his future endeavors. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to share with you the Command Sergeant Major Mark Sablan Ishmael was born on October 2nd, 1964. That's why your classmates were my brother John. He's the son of the late Anthony Benavente Ishmael and Dorothea Sablan Ishmael. He resides in the village of Tedido with Francis Torres Nicholas, his wife of 31 years, and they have 9 children: Mark, Christopher, Francesca, Marvin, Marnisha, Crystal, Marina, Francel, and Christiana. Command Sergeant Major Mark Sablan Ishmael graduated from John F. Kennedy High School on May 30th, 1982. He entered military service with the Guam Army National Guard in May 27th of 1983. As a private, Command Sergeant Major Ishmael was assigned to Company C, 2nd Battalion, Academy of Health Sciences in April of 1984. Command Sergeant Major Ishmael entered the Active Guard Reserve Program as a training NCO in October of 1985. Command Sergeant Major Ishmael was assigned to multiple company-level positions as well as staff positions. Command Sergeant Major Ishmael's units of assignments include the 838th Medical Company Clearing, the G1 Headquarters, Headquarters Detachment Guam, Detachment, the Guam Area Command, the Charlie Company, the 1 through 24th Infantry Battalion Light, and in March of 1996, he was assigned to the Recruiting and Retention Battalion, Guam Army National Guard. Guam Sergeant Major Ishmael was deployed to the Horn of Africa in 2006, and he was promoted to Sergeant Major in November of 2007. He completed Sergeant Major Academy in 2008 at Fort Bliss, Texas. Command Sergeant Major Ishmael was promoted to his current rank of Command Sergeant Major in 2014. Command Sergeant Ishmael's achievements include winning the Guam Army National Guard's Chief 54th competition for the Recruiting and Retention Division, representing Guam during the NGB's Director Strength Maintenance Award Ceremony in 1999. He was selected and given a Certificate of Appreciation as a Modern Army Combative Instructor for the United States Army Sergeant Major's Resident Course and an Instructor for Primary Leadership Course. A Guam Military Academy in 2007, represented and competed for the Guam Army National Guard as a shooter for the M16 rifle and the M16 machine gun teams during the NGB's Winston P. Wilson's Marksmanship Competition. Wow, he's even a sharpshooter. Command Sergeant Major Ishmael's federal and state awards and decorations include the following: the Meritorious Service Medal, the Joint Service Commendation Medal, Army Commendation Medal, Fourth Award, the Guam Commendation Medal, Fourth Award, the Army Achievement Medal, Second Award, Air Force Achievement Medal, Army Good Conduct Medal, the Army Reserve Component Achievement Medal, the Guam Faithful Service, the National Defense Service Medal, Second Award, the Global War on Terrorism Expeditionary Medal, the Global War on Terrorism Service Medal, the Overseas Service Bar, Second Award, the Humanitarian Service Medal, Second Award, the NCO Professional Development Ribbon with Numeral 4 device, the Army Service Ribbon, the Armed Forces Reserve Medal with the M device, the Overseas Ribbon, and the Army Component Service Training Ribbon. Command Sergeant Major Ishmael is a mentor for the students of the JQ San Miguel Elementary School. He is a song leader and teacher for children's ministries with the Family Baptist Church in Dedido, and currently teaches adult Sunday school and is a trustee for the Temple Baptist Church in Chalampago. Command Sergeant Major Ishmael has served his island and country proudly with 31 years of service and will now begin a new chapter of his life in retirement. It is with great honor, ladies and gentlemen, that I take this time present this resolution to you, Command Sergeant Major Mark Sablan Ishmael, on your retirement. We wish you the very best of luck. For all that you've done. God bless you on your new journey in life with your family, with your children, and I heard grandchildren that are here. And I just want to say thank you. Yes. Sana Masi. Before we do the official photo, I'd like for him to give just a few words.
Well, it's a humbling experience to even be here today. I really thank the legislature for spending their time in recognizing my accomplishments. But most of all, I'd like to really thank my family and God. If it wasn't for God and my family, I wouldn't be the person I am today. And so I'd like to give praise to the Lord for all that he's done for me. It's through a lot of prayers. 31 years of active federal service and 33 years altogether with Reserve Component Service was not an accomplishment without God in it. So I'd like to thank my wife also for over 31 years being here with me. She's the person that made me who I am today as well. She's my, here in Guam, the culture is the family culture is the ladies in the was the rock that kept me going. She was my corner man, and I got beat a lot. So she was there to ensure that she motivated me and gave me words of encouragement to get me back out in the fight. So I thank the Lord for my wife as well. And thank you so much.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I forgot to share one vital note, and I wish I had included it, but also Sergeant Major continues to volunteer with the Conservation Volunteer Group, working closely with a lot of other community members and working with the military armed forces, both in Anderson and Navy. And I just want to say, with all the work that you guys do and that you guys continue, again, it's volunteerism and giving a lot of work and labor of love. Ladies and gentlemen, I did notice the presence of Pastor Kelly here, and you know, I'd be remiss if I didn't acknowledge him being here. As we know, Sergeant Major spoke about the presence of believing and knowing that everything is possible with God in our life. I'm sorry I didn't recognize you earlier. Thank you so much. I do know that there's some other folks in the military community that are here on Dunkel and Asizos Masi. To the family and friends, I know my godbrother Paul's back there. He also does a lot of volunteer work with the ROTC, high school students, and them Guam truly being the recruiter's heaven here. You can understand why a lot of the service medal awards go to our representatives, and I just want to say that we are truly blessed. And at this time, if I may, ladies and gentlemen, all of you guys, I see that Sergeant Major's whole family's here, and all of you guys are part of the family. I'd like if we can do one photo with the Ishmael, and the Ishmaels, and then we'll have a group photo, okay? Sinamasi.